बी रेडी, 5 सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट. द एफोरसेड थ्री चेक्स वर प्रेजेंटेड बिफोर द इंडियन ओवरसीज बैंक गांधीनगर जम्मू एंड वर डिसोनर्ड ऑन 6 जनवरी 2004. स्टॉप. रेस्पोंडेंट नंबर वन सर्व्ड नोटिस ऑन रेस्पोंडेंट नंबर टू कंपनी विद ए डिमांड नोटिस सेपरेटली फॉर ऑल द थ्री चेक्स. स्टॉप. रेस्पोंडेंट नंबर टू कंपनी रिप्लाइड टू द सेड नोटिस ऑन 20 जनवरी 2004. इन्फॉर्म्ड रेस्पोंडेंट नंबर वन दैट पेमेंट्स वर स्टॉप्ड बिकॉज ऑफ देयर इनएबिलिटी टू स्टॉप द पायरेसी ड्यू टू विच द केबल ऑपरेटर्स डिड नॉट मेक पेमेंट्स. स्टॉप. देर आफ्टर रेस्पोंडेंट नंबर वन इशूड सेकेंड नोटिस डेटेड 28 जनवरी 2004 ऑन द प्लांट बेस्ड ऑन द सेम फैक्ट्स एंड बेस्ड ऑन द सेम मीमो ऑफ डिसोनर इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ द एफोरसेड थ्री चेक्स. स्टॉप. रेस्पोंडेंट नंबर वन आल्सो इशूड ए कोरिजेंडम ऑफ द सेम डेट टू द सेड नोटिस. स्टॉप. The appellant submitted reply to the said notice on 3rd February 2004. Stop. Respondent number 1 filed a criminal complaint under sections 138 and 141 of the Act on 17 March 2004. Stop. According to appellant, respondent number 1 concealed the material fact of having earlier issued notice dated 14 January 2004 with regard to the aforesaid three checks and by misleading the court got summons issued by Metropolitan Magistrate in complaint number 698 of 2001 to the appellant and respondent number 2 company para. Thereafter respondent number 2 company and appellant jointly filed criminal miscellaneous petition number 2380 of 2004 under section 482 of the criminal procedure code 1973 before the high court of Delhi at New Delhi for quashing the aforesaid criminal complaint filed by respondent number 1. Stop. In its reply, respondent number 1 taken the plea that first notice dated 14 January 2004 was not a notice under section 138 of the Act. Stop. It was contended on behalf of the appellant that he was only vicariously liable on behalf of respondent number 2 company. Stop. Learned counsel for the appellant placed reliance on decisions of this court in support of his claim. Stop. The High Court, by impugned judgment while recording the stand taken by respondent number 1, that letter dated 14 January 2004 constituted a valid notice under section 138 of the Act, and hence the complaint based on second notice against respondent number 2 company was not maintainable and quashed the summon issued by the trial court against respondent number 2 company. Stop. However, so far as appellant is concerned, the High Court, relying on decision of this court in Anil Hada versus Indian Acrylic Limited 2001 SCC 1, held that the proceeding against the director can be issued even in absence of the company being implicated. Stop. The High Court further held that the summoning order was valid since the first notice was not addressed to the appellant and the second notice, which was also addressed to the appellant, was issued within time, and therefore criminal complaint filed by respondent number 1 against the appellant on the basis of the said notice is maintainable. Stop. Learned counsel appearing on behalf of the appellant contended that the order of the High Court is contrary to the law, inasmuch as this is not a case where proceedings were initiated against the managing director alone. Stop. On the contrary, the proceedings are instituted against the company obligor accused and its managing director. Stop. In the event of the company obligor accused being let off, the same cannot continue against the managing director, who admittedly is only vicariously liable. Stop.